Now we'll take up a very important part of your NCERT syllabus in thermodynamics, that is Carnot cycle. Alright, so in this section we are trying to derive the efficiency of the Carnot cycle. Fine. Now what is Carnot cycle? Carnot cycle is a heat engine. Okay, it is a heat engine which is reversible in nature. Now what is heat engine? Heat engine operates between two temperatures, T1 and T2. Okay, and T1 is greater than T2. Okay, it takes heat Q1 at higher temperature and releases heat to the colder temperature. Fine, and does some work. Fine, this hotter temperature is the temperature at the combustion chamber. So this temperature is achieved by burning fuel. For example, if it is a petrol engine, the burning of petrol will cause a higher temperature. Okay, so this is that temperature. Now this heat Q2 is released in the form of exhaust to the surrounding. Alright, so this T2 is surrounding temperature. Fine, and then in this process it does some work W. Okay, now one thing we need to understand clearly is any engine follows a cycle. Okay, so it is a cyclic process. Fine, so for cyclic process, if we apply first law of thermodynamics, which says delta Q is delta U plus W, since entropy is a state function and if it comes back at the same point again and again, so for one complete cycle delta U is 0, right? What is delta Q for one complete cycle? Delta Q is heat absorbed minus heat released. This should be equal to W, right? Now one thing we should notice here is that heat is absorbed at constant temperature T1 and heat is released at constant temperature T2. Okay, so if we plot this cycle in a PV graph, then there will be two processes at constant temperature. Let's suppose this is temperature T1 and this is temperature T2, and this is how constant temperature curve will look like. Okay, a constant temperature curve in a PV graph is this. PV is a constant, right? If temperature is constant, so this is one temperature which is higher, T1, and this is another temperature, T2, which is lower temperature, right? So these are two isotherms, we call it. Fine, so there are two such processes. Now it has to be a cycle, right? So we need to connect these two processes which are at constant temperature. Now what do you think these two connecting lines, what kind of processes these are? Heat is absorbed only at T1 and heat is released only at T2. Whatever processes are these, heat must not be exchanged with the surrounding. So it must be adiabatic process. Fine. So let us write down. It follows a cyclic process in which 1 to 2 and 3 to 4 is isothermal in nature. And 2 to 3 and 4 to 1 is adiabatic process. Okay. Now efficiency of any engine is what? Work done, which is a useful thing, divided by how much heat or energy you are giving to the engine. Right? So it must be work done divided by what heat you are giving to the engine. You are giving Q1, right? Q2 is actually rejected to the surrounding. So this must be the efficiency, right? And work done from here, let us call this equation number 1, is what? Q1 minus Q2 divided by Q1, right? So this comes out to be 1 minus Q2 by Q1. Fine? So this is the efficiency of a Carnot cycle. But the problem is that Q1 and Q2, they are very difficult to measure. What is given right now is temperature of the flame inside the cylinder and the surrounding temperature. So can I find out efficiency in terms of temperature? Then it will be very easy for me to get the efficiency of Carnot cycle directly if I know the temperatures. Okay. In order to achieve that, we need to find Q1 and Q2 in terms of temperature. Okay. So let us see how we can do that. So let me write at the corner what we have just got. Efficiency is 1 divided by Q2 divided by Q1. Okay, now for 1 to 2, only for 1 to 2 process, I am going to apply first law of thermodynamics. First law of thermodynamics says delta Q is delta U plus W. Okay, when we apply for entire cycle, then delta U was 0 because it is a cyclic process, right? What will be delta U when it goes from 1 to 2? It's an isothermal, right? Temperature is fixed from 1 to 2. So even in 1 to 2 process as well, delta U is 0. Okay, not because it is cyclic process, but because it is at a constant temperature. Right? And what is delta Q from 1 to 2? Delta Q is heat absorbed by the gas, which is Q1, will be equal to W from 1 to 2. Fine? And I know that work done in isothermal process is Nr T1 log of V2 by V1. Fine? So V2 is volume at 0.2 and V1 is volume at 0.1. Okay. Similarly, for 3 to 4 process, if I apply first law thermodynamics, delta U is again 0 because temperature is again fixed at T2, right? What is delta Q? Now delta Q will be minus of Q2 because Q2 is heat which is given out from the system. So delta Q is minus of Q2. This must be equal to the work done. Okay? Work done from 3 to 4. Okay. This is NRT2. So Q2 is equal to what? Minus Q2 is that. So Q2 is minus goes there and log inside whatever is there inside the log, it will invert. So it becomes NRT2 log of V3 by V4. Okay. Now when I substitute their efficiency as 1 minus Q2 by Q1, what will happen is that a term log V2 by V1 divided by log V3 by V4 will also come. But I don't even know the volume at that moment, right? So, let us just mark these equations second and third. And can I use some other property here in the cycle to arrive at the volume, relation between the volumes? Have I used that this is isotherm? This T1 and T2? Yes, we did it here, right? We found out work done. This is the formula for work done in isothermal process, right? But did we use the fact that 2 to 3 and 4 to 1, they are adiabatic processes? We have not, right? So let us use those facts also. So for 2 to 3, we know for adiabatic process, TV raised to the power gamma minus 1 is a constant, right? That is a process equation for adiabatic. So for 2 to 3, I have T2 V2 gamma minus 1 equals 2. Okay, sorry. At point number 2, temperature is T1. So I'll write down here T1. Then at point number 3, temperature is T2. T2 V3 gamma minus 1. Okay, we have used the fact that 2 to 3 is adiabatic process, and in an adiabatic process, TV raised to the power gamma minus 1 is a constant. Okay, so similarly, for 4 to 1, we have temperature at point number 4 is T2. So I'll write there for point number 4, T2, this is V4, gamma minus 1. This must be equal to, at point number 1, temperature is T1, volume is V1 to the power V1, right? So it will be V1 to the power gamma minus 1. So these are equation number 4 and so what I will do now is I will divide equation number 4 with 5. I will divide left hand side of 4 with left hand side of 5. So what will happen? T1 will go away. So I will get V2 by V1 raised to the power gamma minus 1 is equal to V3 by V4 raised to the power gamma minus 1. So this will give me V2 by V1 equals to V3 by V4. So this is a very important relation we have got from equation number 4 and 5. Okay? If this is true, then log of V3 by V4 is equal to log of V2 by V1, right? So when I divide Q1 from Q2, Q2 from Q1, I get this as nRT1 log of V2 by V1 n into r get cancelled, and since V2 by V1 is equal to V3 by V4, so even this get cancelled. So Q1 by Q2 is nothing but T1 by T2. So we have got Q1 by Q2 equals to T1 by T2, right? And we know that efficiency is equal to 1 minus Q2 by Q1. Right? So when I use Q1 by Q2 equals to T1 by T2 in the efficiency equation, I'll get efficiency equals to 1 minus T2 by T1. Right? So now we have got efficiency in terms of the temperatures. Now you must be using temperature in Kelvin. Right? At times temperature will be given in degree Celsius. So you have to convert in Kelvin. And also T2 is lower temperature and T1 is higher temperature. Okay. Now you can also, you know, easily judge which temperature is lower,
and which temperature is higher by looking at the efficiency formula. Because if T2 is the higher temperature, efficiency will come out to be negative. That doesn't make any sense, right? So T2 must be lower temperature and T1 is higher temperature. Okay.